And it was at that moment, he said, was the hardest of his life. And it was at that moment that he turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a very, very profound dua. And the dua of Taif, I advise everyone to really study this dua, because within this dua is a formula for healing. It's a formula for how to really deal with a broken heart. First thing he does, he says, I complain to you. So this is also a very important concept when it comes to dealing with pain. And that is that we don't complain about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't say, Ya Allah, it's not fair. Ya Allah, why me? Right? That is something that is a contradiction of sabr. But we complain to Allah. And there's a very, very deep difference. Complaining about Allah is when you are saying, why me? It's not fair. How could you do this to me, God? Complaining to Allah is when you turn to Allah and say, this is hard and I need help. And that's what Allah wants from us. And what's so profound is that's what prophets did. Look at Yaqub alayhi salam. Like Yaqub alayhi salam, his patience is referred to as sabrun jamil, right? He had beautiful patience. And look at his dua, innama ashku bathi wa huzni ilallah. He says that indeed I complain of my suffering and my sadness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he was also complaining to Allah. He's not complaining about Allah. He's not saying it's not fair. How could you take Yusuf from me? He's turning to Allah and he's saying, I am suffering. I am sad. That is what prophets did. And this actually is the most powerful way to heal a broken heart, is to take the broken heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not to pretend that it doesn't hurt, not to pretend that you're strong, not to pretend that you've got it all together, you've got it all figured out. That's only going to make you suffer more. But to take that brokenness and turn to Allah with the brokenness, and Allah heals the broken hearts. And Allah loves when we turn to Him. So what happens is when we do that, a few things happen. Number one, we actually get closer to Allah through that broken heart. And this is why, subhanAllah, bringing it back to this concept of transformation, that not only can we transform a broken heart, but we can also transform through a broken heart. That the brokenness itself changes us. And if we do it right, it makes us better. It makes us stronger. It makes us it develops us. It grows us. And so you see that transformation actually can happen through the broken heart itself. We hate to feel pain. I mean, that is just part of human nature. But I'm going to kind of change your perspective a little bit here, inshallah. And that is, look at a person who goes to the gym, right? A person who wants to get in shape, a person who wants to build muscle. My question to you is, what do they do, right? If someone wants to get strong, do they sit on the couch and get comfortable? Or do they have to go to the gym and lift weight, right? And so we understand this concept in the physical world that in order to get stronger, in order to get fit, you have to actually do work. You have to actually struggle a bit. Yeah. You have to actually lift weight. If I tell a personal trainer, hey, I want to be in shape, right? I want to be strong. I want to be fit. That trainer isn't going to tell you how to sit on the couch. That trainer is not going to get you comfortable. In fact, anyone who's gone to a trainer knows it's not comfortable. It's not necessarily going to be something that's easy, right? In fact, it involves some struggle, and it may involve some literal pain, right? No pain, no gain. Now, that pain of lifting and the pain that anyone who goes to the gym knows that comes after is part of the process. It's part of the process of what? You know, you never see, if you told your trainer, I want to be strong and I want to be fit, right? And then your trainer says, okay, here's how you're going to do it. This is what you're going to do. This is your regimen. You see that weight over there, you're going to have to pick it. You're going to have to lift it. No, but it hurts. But you're going to have to do it. That's how you're going to get fit. That's how you're going to get strong. You're not going to go and get angry at the trainer and say, why'd you do this to me? How could you make me go to the gym? Or how could you make me lift that weight? How could you make me do resistance training? How could you do this? And you're not going to get angry because you know that there's a purpose. You know that this period of pain, this period of struggle is for a purpose. And that purpose is to make you stronger. And that purpose is to develop you, literally to grow you. And it's exactly the same thing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the pain that we experience in life. But we have to respond in the right way in order for it to grow us, in order for it to make us stronger. We have to respond in the right way. Because just like at the gym, if you do it wrong, you can injure yourself. And in fact, you can really, really hurt yourself, right? It's the same thing, that if we don't respond properly, if we don't understand how to deal with the pain, if we don't understand how to respond to the broken heart, then we can actually suffer greatly. And that's why it's so important that we learn these tools and we have the right concepts and we respond properly. الأرض ميدان النسير